This video is about side adjustment of the feed dog. And you are looking at the feed dog of a Singer 201. This video will actually apply to a lot of Winter's machines because the principle here is the same. You see, it works very well and no problems here. Now I have removed the needle plate. And the reason is, if you look very carefully here, you can see that the needle plate is broken at this particular position there. And actually it was also bent a little down, but I decided to order a new needle plate. And it looks like this. And then I mounted it. But maybe you can see here that the tolerances to the feed dog are a lot less than before. Remove it again, and you can compare it to the old one. Here you got much more air to the side of the feed dogs than on this new one I got. And when I started to install this, I got problems because the feed dog started to grind against the side here. And that's of course not that good. You couldn't, when it's loose like this, there's no problem, but when you tighten the screws, then you had this grinding against the side. And then I had to find out how to adjust that. This is the downside of the machine. And I'll show you a little more about the feed dog here. What you see here is actually a part of a steel that comes further down here and over here. And it is attached to the feed dog. There is two kind of mechanisms. This one up here is for the control of the up-down movement on the feed dog. And this mechanism here is for the forward and backwards movement of the feed dog. And it is so that the feed dog is actually quite loose attached to the upper part here, but this is quite firmly attached to the one low below there, and there is an axle more there, you can see. So what actually controls the sidewards thing with this feed dog is this big axle here, and it is attached here to the side. You can see there is a screw there, and it is what is called a cone screw, a cone point screw, and I have loosened it from the other side, and there you can see how it looks like. And it is actually two parts. There is a nut there and there's a screw, and it goes into a thread. By loosening the nut, you are able to move this cone point screw to the right or to the left, and it will move the feed dog as well. You've got exactly the same screw over here, and I have that's the one I removed just so you could see it. You can see it's quite loose now, but it's exactly the same. For me, it was a little above a quarter turn. I had to make the adjustment to make it right. When you tighten the screws again, you need the axle to be just loose, but nothing more. So you have to be quite precise in the way you adjust these screws for it to fix again. Okay, and that's how you adjust the side movement of the feed dog.